Hello, everybody. We welcome you to the first actual episode of the Passport Bros Ambassador. Your host, that's me, Abu Naima, and basically breaking down some of the do's and don'ts in the beginning. A brother had contacted me in regards to information on the Passport Bros. Okay, and so what I'm gonna say on that is this right here. Passport Bros started off as a concept, and like most things, people get called something and then they just roll with it. You know what I mean? So they started being coined or called the Passport Bros, as far as I understand. Now, prior to all of this calling brothers Passport Bros and so forth and so on, I had already been doing this. You know what I mean? I flew overseas my first time in 1996, which I spoke about this prior on my podcast, which is called The Bowtie Chronicles, which was basically dealing with repatriation of African Americans going back and forth, returning to Africa from the diaspora, and also dealing with reparations. But in relation to the topic of the Passport Bros, after watching the Phil Scott show and a lot of traction and blowback that the brothers are getting, I thought it was important to go ahead and get into that arena and start talking about the topic. Because myself, I've been doing this for years. I've been overseas for the last going on 23 years. Okay. And happily married. Every marriage has ups and downs, but happily married going on 20 years next year. And so the topic of the Passport Bros is something that me and a couple of other brothers that have been living inside of Africa for the last 27 years, we've already experienced all this right here. And so I thought it was important to go ahead and make sure that they have a platform to voice their opinions and also point out do's and don'ts and make things clear as to how brothers that are actually anticipating, because this is what was asked of me by one brother. He wanted to know how could he join. I said, you don't have to join, brother, but I'm gonna put out games so as to fill brothers in on what needs to be done if you want to do it. And also bridge the gap so that you have people that you need to be in contact with. Okay. And so don't limit yourself. It's just not about going to Cuba and going to the Dominican Republic, because you don't know what you're getting in those situations. Okay, for me, it depends on what you plan on doing. Okay, if, and I'm not limiting it to brothers who are, because this thing is open. It's about any brother who is tired of the BS with modern women. Okay, and the whole, you know, situation that brothers are into the West. You know, you get caught up to the point where, you know, it's frustrating. I know that. I've been there. You know what I mean? And what I would say is this right here. For the most part, you need to find out what it is that you want to do. Do you want to get married, or do you just want to experience, you know what I mean, traveling, you know what I mean? So that's the first thing that you need to ask yourself. Okay, for me, myself, I've always been married, you know what I mean? I'm not, you know, I gave all that stuff up back in the streets, you know, and so I stay married. And like I said before, to either one, two, or three if possible. You know what I mean? So I don't believe in being single. That's just not something that I do. But for brothers that want to do that, you know, that's on them. I'm not against what they do. You know what I mean? But at the same time, as an original Passport Bro, you know what I mean? I'm just here to not judge anybody, but actually just break down and give, you know, what you should do, how you should do it if you're trying to get married, okay? For the other brothers that are trying to just, you know, trying to get into relationships before they get married and experience themselves and so forth like that, hey, I'm not, you know, I would advise a brother to get married. That's what I would advise. Because if you're going to a place where women are groomed for marriage, then of course the families are going to shun other than that, especially if they're in parts of Africa and places where they come from sound families. Now, you can go to certain places and you're going to end up with women that are not coming from sound family backgrounds also. And then you're going to have some of the same issues. And I don't want brothers to get the illusion that, oh, when you leave the West, the serpent head of feminism hasn't arrived. It's not true. It's all over the world. But there are certain things that you need to look out for in order to not allow that to affect you. First, I'm going to talk about, without further ado, I'm just going to talk about what brothers need to do. If you don't have a passport, you need to try to get a passport and get one as soon as possible. Back in the day when I first got my passport, it was $50. Now them jokers are like $100 and something. So, and it make it harder for people to get passports. Brothers that have issues with child support and so forth like that, they're going to stop you from getting a passport. So brothers that have access to getting passports, you need to go down to your local office as soon as you get money in your pocket. Boom, go get a passport as soon as possible. Other things, determine what you want. Okay, what I'm going to do in up and coming weeks when I get my platform up and running, I just touched back down in another country. So I'm not as situated as I would like to be. Okay, but what I will be doing sometime at the start of next year is actually interviewing certain sisters and seeing what they would like in a man. Dealing with women that are primarily from Africa, and also there are some Asian women on this side over here where I'm at, and so that is kind of like what I, you know, will be providing. Okay, and also on the show, when the numbers get up, then we have lives, or we can call in brothers and let brothers share their experiences, do an interview with different brothers, let sisters call in also, and open up different topics. Okay, one of the first things that I would talk about right here today is just about knowing what your goals are. Set your goals, know what you want to do. Okay. And after you set your goals and you know what you want to do, then we can go ahead and assist you and you can benefit from programs that'll be on that I'm going to be having on the podcast. You can benefit from the programs by simply tuning in to the stuff that you want to, that you want to listen to, because a lot of stuff is not going to be pertaining to you. A lot of stuff is going to be pertaining to people that want to be married. A lot of stuff is going to be pertaining to people that are not really concerned with getting married. You know what I mean? So what you need to do. Set a goal. Know what you want to do. First goal is to get your passport. Okay. The difference between a passport and a passport ID. Okay. Passport ID is an ID that allows you travel inside of the Americas. The Americas meaning the Caribbean and so forth. A lot of people think that that's a passport. It is not a passport. You can't go outside of the Americas without that. All right, so you have to have a passport. It has to have pages in it. And you saw the picture on the, that's what a passport looks like, has pages in it, okay? And so that's what you need to get, okay? And that right there would allow you to cross over into other countries and cross overseas, you know what I mean? Like I said before, I got brothers that are married in all these different places, you name it. And so my plan is to assist brothers in ways that I can with hooking brothers up, you know what I mean? And of course, we will be vetting brothers. Why? Why do we need to vet brothers? It's because if we go to hook a brother up with people that we know, we have to know that the brother's sound. And if you're not sound, then you mess it up for all of us and you give us a bad name. And so we can't allow that, you know what I mean? And so deadbeat brothers, you know what I'm saying? You need to get your acts together. Get your act together, because you got a lot of brothers come overseas and they feel like, you know, oh, we over here now, y'all should be taking care of us. It's the same situation that happened when brothers went back to Ghana, and also some brothers went to Gambia, because I got brothers in Ghana and Gambia, Senegal, everywhere. And I network with a lot of brothers. And so we need brothers that are productive workers, brothers who have something going for themselves and want to take care of family, because we can't hook you up with, everybody falls on hard times, even myself. But that don't stop us from pushing forward and actually working. So you got to be in the forefront of taking care of a family in order for us to hook you up with people so that you can. You know what I'm saying? If you want to attract feminine energy, okay, you have to be masculine. Okay.